Hello and welcome to Web Applications for Everybody. Today we are going to play with NGROK. NGROK is awesome. You'll wonder how you ever got along without it. But chances are good that the reason you're playing with NGROK is that you were working on one of the assignments that requires NGROK. And so there's a little video to use NGROK. We got a Mac version. This is the Windows version. And so the idea is you're going to play a guessing game. Play this guessing game, and you're too low, and I change it to 13, it's still too low, and so you have to send this guessing game to the autograder. And so the autograder's here, and the way it works is this autograder is going to hit this web server and run things, and it's going to send a page, it's going to ask for a page, so it hit this page right here, and it got this text back. Now it's unhappy because it was looking for the title Charles Severance, and the way this assignment works is you have to have the correct answer. But the problem becomes if you have this running on localhost, it's not going to work. So let me grab this sample code, sample array code, and download it. Oops, not that one. I'm going to save this arrays, save this file. So I'm going to open this. And so it's in downloads, and it's a zip file of arrays. And so what I'm going to do is I'm going to drag this into my htdocs. I need a new folder. How do you get a new folder here? A new control N gets me a new folder. I'm not much a whiz, so I got to get to xamp, htdocs. And I'm going to pull this code right here for this arrays code. I'm going to pull this into this ASN, right? So now let me open that up in Atom. So I am in htdocs, ASSN, and I have this folder called arrays. Okay, and so I have this code guess, and I want to run this code. So now I'm going to start my XAMPP. Let's start here with XAMPP. Down here, this XAMPP control panel, I am going to make my life nice, and I'm going to pin this to my taskbar so I don't have to find this anymore. So now I don't have to click it in there. I am going to click it here. And so XAMPP, I'm done with this little folder and get rid of that. So let's start our Apache. And our MySQL. If you have trouble with these, always reboot your computer because these ports, only one application can run on it. And if you do something wrong and you don't stop this the right way and you get messed up, these things won't restart because port 80 or port 443 or 3306 will be taken. So just start over. But so we'll test, but this worked. We'll go to the admin page and there we have XAMPP. And if I go to ASSN instead of slash dashboard, that's where my, oops, typed that wrong. So under arrays, and I have guess.php. Okay, and so this I can test it with question mark guess equals 42. And wow, I'm a great guesser. Because 42 is always the good answer to anything, because it's the answer to a lot of things. So 42. So I am now going to go back to the autograder. Goodbye. So I'm going to run the autograder again. And what I want the autograder to do is instead of grading this, I want the autograder to grade my code running on localhost. So I'm going to copy that. It's not going to work, because this code is running in the real internet, and this code is running in my desktop, and things on the internet can't, I can connect out to the network, but I can't connect in. It's like there's a firewall stopping things. So this is going to blow up horribly because this server, WA4E.com, is unable to talk to my laptop. My laptop can talk to it, but it can't talk to my laptop. So whatever it did, it wasn't working very well. I don't know what localhost port 80 is or what's out there, but there's something out there. I don't know. So it blew up. But there's some server out there with named localhost of all the crazy things. But that's not what we want to do. So that's not working. It's not talking to yours. So we're going to use this thing called NGROK. So what is NGROK? So NGROK is it's sort of a firewall buster. Now the way this works, let me see if my scribbler can scribble on this. Scribble. So the way this works is the real internet. Your XAMPP is running here, right? It's running here on your laptop. And you can talk to port 80 here, right? You're running a browser here and a server there. You can talk back and forth to yourselves, okay? And that's what's going on. But WA4E is out here, and it 4E is out here, and it can't make it. It crashes. So what happens is you've got to run a piece of code on your laptop that effectively breaks a hole and makes it so that WA4E can come through that and talk to your computer and get it back. And this is called a secure tunnel. But the tunnel doesn't exist without this NGROK thing, and it only exists when you set it up. And so NGROK is a free service from this awesome company called NGROK.com that you run it on your laptop and it opens up, and then NGROK gives you a temporary permanent address, a temporary real address on the real internet for your code. So let's do it. So let's download it. So we're downloading it. I'm going to download Windows 64-bit. And I'm going to open it. And I am going to, I hope I could make this a real copy rather than a link. Yeah. So yeah, I got NGROK. Now don't run it from here because this is actually inside of a zip file, so compressed folder tools. So that's why I copied it to my desktop. Okay. So I'm going to close that. And I don't really need NGROK anymore other than maybe show you the picture. I'll show you the picture because I love that picture. It's the most awesome picture right there. Hi, NGROK's picture. And so now, look at this. So I got localhost here. This is localhost. This is running on my localhost. Now I need to make it so NGROK can talk to me. And so I'm going to start a command prompt up. Command. And I'm going to go into my desktop. And if I do a dir, you will see that there is a thing called ngrok.exe. Now, to establish the tunnel, so we're here, I'm going to run a command here that is going to effectively get an address on ngrok.com and then start forwarding stuff backwards. We're like pulling in these things, but ngrok is going to take care of this. You'll see it in a second. So when I come over here, I'm going to type ngrok. HTTP, that's the protocol that we want to fake, and we want to do this on port 80. So the port 80 on our localhost is going to be effectively forwarded out to the real internet through NGROK. And so what happens is every time NGROK starts up, it's going to give you a brand new address. And that, so if and then Control-C quits it, but we won't do that yet. So hang on, let me change the size of my screen a little bit so you sort of can watch a little bit what's happening over here. Yeah, so here we go. Let me see, I gotta cut this. Come on. Cut and paste this. Edit. Copy. And then I'm gonna go over here in a new tab and I'm gonna paste that in. And so now that is my localhost Apache XAMPP running. And look. That's my dashboard, right? That's the same thing that's on my localhost. That's mine. That's not anyone else's. This is a real live address now for the slash dashboard. And you can actually see as this thing talks, the GET request. Remember all that stuff about HTTP we're talking about? It's faking that. The data is going to NGROK and then being forwarded back down this application and then copied into your XAMPP and then copied back out. So it's really super cool. So what you do is you make sure that this works, and then what you do is you go over here and you grab this path, starting with the slash ASSN, copy that, and then come over here, get rid of the dashboard bit, and paste that. And so that says run guest.php on my localhost. So you see it came here. Right, it just did this. It just grabbed that, and my browser in the outside world is there. And so I can say guess equals 42. Now, what's cool about this now is I can go and run this autograder and give it this URL. So I always like to get to the point where I have the NGROK URL working in my browser. Don't say guess equals 42. That will probably confuse it. So I'm put that in. So I'm going to say, please autograde that URL. So that's what I'm putting in right here. Autograde that URL. Now the autograder is going to contact your laptop. And you can watch over here. It's going to be chat, 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 chat. You can even see what URLs it's sending if you want. Let me move this over just a little more. Evaluate. See, it made a series of requests. You saw it go by over here, right? Now, it didn't find, now the way the autograder works is it's looking for something. It wasn't happy. It didn't find Chuck Severance in the tag. And that's because it says Charles Severance in the sample code. This worked. It's looking for missing guest parameter. And it got, it got missing guest parameter on that one. So you can toggle these on and off. You can see this is the URL that it hits, and this is the page it got from your application. And so you, when you see these red things, kind of look at the HTML, like what went wrong? Oh, okay. So this one went right, this one went right. But the problem is for this particular assignment, I got to change it. So I got to change the name of this. Come on, Adam. Oh, Adam's over here. Come over. No, Adam, I don't want a bunch of copies of you. It's already over here. Guest.php. So I got to change this. I'm changing this on my computer, right? And I'm going to save it. Control S. And then I am going to rerun. Come back over here. Rerun the autograder, and you'll see this error is going to go away because I fixed it. But it is contacting the application running on my laptop. So that fixes it. The other bug I've got is 37 is the correct answer. Everybody gets a different correct answer, and so these aren't working, and so I got to change it from 42 to 37, control save that, and then you can run this again on the autograder, rerun the test, and now I got no errors. Okay, and so we sent the grade up and we're good to go. Okay, so that is a lot of fun. NGROK is awesome. Oh, and by the way, let's finish up NGROK here. If I hit Control C in this window, NGROK goes away, and now this URL will fail because we have broken this connection. This connection only exists while that code's running. So now the world is going to try to come in again, but you have broken this side, right? You know, you had this like NGROK running that sort of extended your computer out into the internet and let things come in. But now you have broken this. As soon as I hit Control C over here, as soon as I hit Control C over there, it broke this thing. And so it wasn't any good. And so now the world can still try to come in, but there's nothing there. And you'll see what happens. You'll see what happens when we try to come in. And that is, my browser is going to go through NGROK.io, but it's been closed down. And this program's not running, and so it's not there. And so there is no other side anymore. And so that's why this is only working when you're running that code. So you're totally controlling when it happens. And every time you run it, let me run it again, you get a different address. So I ran it again, and now I'm on a different address. And now I'll stop it. So it's only there when you say it, and every time you start it, you get a different address. So it's hard for people to guess your address. But anyone on the internet could literally, while you're running NGROK, talk to your application. And so, I hope that was helpful to you and lets you use NGROK on Windows. Okay? Cheers.